Bonjour, Year 11. It's Madame Jones.
And Madame Routley.
And we're here to give you some last-minute tips before your speaking exam.
As you know, the speaking exam is divided into three sections. For the role play, keep it short and simple. For the photo card, make sure you develop your answers. And for the general conversation, it's time to show off your tenses and aim high phrases. In the exam, an invigilator will hand you a role play card and a photo card. You will have 12 minutes to prepare what you want to say. Remember to spend the bulk of the time on the photo card, as this is worth the most amount of marks. We would recommend spending 8 minutes on the photo card, developing your answers as much as possible, and 4 minutes on the role play, keeping it simple.
When you're preparing for the photo, remember that there will be 5 bullet points. However, they're always in the same order.
As I usually say, DOPFO. Description, opinion, past, future, and another opinion.
Now, this question is worth a lot of marks, so don't just give one sentence answers for each bullet point. You really need to develop them. Remember that on the teacher's script, after we have asked you the question, we will ask you autre chose. This means anything else. Do not panic about this, but try to make sure that you have something extra that you could add for when the teacher says autre chose.
In order to develop your answers for bullet point number one about description, remember the structure that we have been learning. What, where, action, emotion. The sentence starters for these are sur la photo il y a, je pense qu'ils sont, ils sont en train de, always followed by an infinitive verb, and ils ont l'air.
And if you've not yet learned these phrases off by heart, pause this video and spend some time practicing them now. Remember, your teacher will ask autre chose, anything else? Here are some ideas for what you could say when you hear your teacher ask that. You could add an opinion, a weather phrase, an item of clothing, or you could be very inventive and describe one of the people in the photo as a friend or relative.
In order to develop the opinion bullet point, don't forget about that really catchy song, the YMCA. We start with mentioning yourself, so give your opinion, then mention somebody else, for example, mon ami or ma mère m'a dit que, give somebody else's ideas. Then contrast, cependant, elle est folle, for example, and then add extra information, aussi. You could add an example of something you've done or give anything extra that you can. Have a look at the example below.
And remember, there are lots of phrases that you can add to make your vocabulary more interesting. These green phrases are aim high phrases that you will have learned in class. You can add them at the start of an opinion sentence. For example, selon moi, according to me, cafes are really great. It just makes your opinion sound more interesting. These purple phrases are intensifiers. Words like very or quite or so or really or a little bit. Instead of just saying it's great, you could say it's really great, and this will get you higher marks. The phrases in red are more interesting words than just, for example, bon or fantastique. You want to try to use phrases that other students won't use, like sans ça, génial, formidable, or chouette. That one's quite old-fashioned, but it's very perfectly fine to use in your exam. Here are some negative ones. Nul, barbon, morne. Morne is one that not a lot of pupils will know. It means gloomy. Now let's look at developing bullet points 3 and 4, the past and the future tense. For the past tense, you should know a list of basic sentence starters like the one shown here. Start with a simple sentence and then you can add your opinion to develop your answer. To really wow the examiner, you can use après avoir, which means after having. All you need to do is add your previous verb to après avoir. For example, après avoir visité would mean after having visited. All you need now is a second past tense sentence. For example, you could say, j'ai visité le Tour Eiffel. C'était fantastique. Après avoir visité le Tour Eiffel, j'ai mangé une croissant. What a beautifully developed response.
For the future tense, again, you should have some basic sentence starters. The two easiest ones to remember are je voudrais and je vais. Just remember to follow them with an infinitive verb. For example, je voudrais aller or je vais visiter. Giving your opinion in the future is easy. Either use il sera, it will be, or il serait, it would be. To really wow the examiner, you can then use a high-level phrase such as si j'étais riche, je voudrais plus an infinitive, meaning if I were rich, I would like to do something.
When you're preparing for the role play, always start by reading the top part, which is written in English. It tells you the exact situation that you're going to be acting out. For example, some of them say things like, you're in a shop in France and the teacher is playing the role of the shopkeeper. Often the teacher is playing the role of a French exchange partner, or sometimes they are an employer and you're looking for a job. Be careful. If it's one of the formal situations, like looking for a job or speaking to a head teacher, you need to refer to the teacher as vous. If it's your friend, you can call the teacher tu. If you read this section at the top, it's really useful in working out what the clues mean. Sometimes in the clues, there might be a word that you do not understand. However, if you read the situation, you can probably get the gist of what it is you need to say in this part of the test.
The foundation exam has one surprise question, shown by an exclamation mark. Usually, but no promises, the surprise is something to do with numbers. For example, your birthday, a time, a date, a phone number, the amount of people at a table, etc. The foundation exam has one question that you need to ask the teacher. This is shown with a question mark. Remember, there are three really easy structures that you can use to create a question. The first is on peut plus an infinitive, can we? For example, can we go somewhere? The second is il y a plus a noun, is there or are there? For example, are there any changing rooms? And the third one, aimes-tu or aimez-vous, do you like? Just remember to be aware if you need to use the tu form or the vous form in the role play. Now is time for the most important part of the speaking exam, the general conversation. It's worth 36 out of 70 marks, and it's the part that you've been preparing the most for over the last 2 years. You will be speaking about your chosen topic with some follow-up questions after your introduction, and then you will have questions on a random topic from the other ones that we have been learning. To revise for these, practice your introduction as much as possible, along with follow-up questions on that topic. Also, you need to practice questions on all of the other topics from the themes we have studied. If you would like to practice with us, Miss Jones is going to read out some of the questions now. Pause the video and have a go at responding.
Although we are not allowed to tell you the exact questions that will come up in the general conversation, remember that we are always looking to hear you use opinions, past and future. Here are some example sentences. I am going to read out the questions and then you can pause the video and say an answer. I've included an aim high phrase box so that you can have a look through and make sure you're adding in some really impressive phrases. Tu préfères sortir en famille ou avec tes copains? Qu'est-ce que tu as fait le week-end dernier? Comment vas-tu fêter ton prochain anniversaire? Here are some example questions for theme 2, local area and holidays. pause the video and you can practice answering. Parle-moi de ta ville. Où as-tu passé tes vacances l'année dernière? Comment seraient tes vacances idéales? Here are some sample questions on school, theme 3. Quelles sont les différences entre les écoles en France et en Angleterre? Décris ta journée scolaire d'hier. Que voudrais-tu changer dans ton école? Here are some sample questions from theme 4, Future Study and Employment. As-tu un petit job? Quel métier aimais-tu quand tu étais petit? Qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire après avoir fini au collège? And for the final theme, theme 5, we have, à ton avis, quel sera le plus grand problème environnemental pour la planète à l'avenir et pourquoi? Qu'est-ce que tu as déjà fait pour sauver la planète? Tu voudrais faire du travail bénévole à l'avenir? So that's it. Thank you for listening to our video. We're really looking forward to seeing you in these exams. You deserve to do really well and make yourself really proud because you've been working so hard on French for all of these years. So we know that you're going to be amazing.
Don't forget to check your time, check your chosen topic, and just as important, get some rest.
Bon courage!
Bonne chance!